An EPIRB is an emergency position indicating radio beacon, which is used as a distress alerting system, indicating to search and rescue authorities both the identity and position of a vessel, which is in grave and imminent danger and requires immediate assistance. EPIRB is a small, self-contained, battery-operated radio transmitter which is both watertight and buoyant. They also transmit a distinctive swept audio tone signal on the International Aeronautical Distress Frequencies of 121.5 MHz for homing purposes by search and rescue aircraft. EPIRBs can also transmit a GNSS position, provided it is fed from an internal or external GNSS device. The hydrostatic release in the bracket is designed to release the beacon when the bracket is submerged to a certain depth. EPIRBs may either be portable and capable of being manually activated or they must be able to be deployed automatically without any operator intervention. EPIRB divided for two categories. Category 2 is manually activated and Category 1 has an automatic release and deployment mechanism. This usually allows the EPIRB to be mounted externally and to be deployed automatically once it is below 6 feet of water, allowing the unit to float to the surface and transmit its emergency message. As per IMO Resolution MSC-471, all vessels required to be equipped with EPIRB Category 1, with automatic release and deployment mechanism. EPIRB supplied with a plastic enclosure in which the C switch of the EPIRB is deactivated. The plastic enclosure contains a spring-loaded lever which automatically pushes the enclosure lid off and releases the EPIRB if the vessel sinks. This automatic ejection is controlled by a device called hydrostatic release unit that will automatically release the EPIRB once a depth of approximately 4 to 5 meters is reached. EPIRB uses the COSPAS-SARSAT system. It operates all over the globe without geographical restrictions. The system comprises of a space segment operating in low Earth orbit and geostationary orbit. A ground segment consisting of satellite receiving stations, known as local user terminals and data distribution centers. I would like to divide EPIRBs into two groups, old and new. Old models of EPIRBs, installed on vessels before July 2022, complied with the requirements of Resolution A810, which did not mandate the presence of GPS in the device. However, new EPIRBs installed on board vessels after the specified date must adhere to the standards outlined in Resolution MS-471 Annex 24. These standards stipulate the mandatory inclusion of a GNSS receiver and automatic identification system in the EPIRB. A distinguishing feature of modern EPIRBs, compared to old types of emergency radio beacons, is that they include a GPS receiver and transmit their location, typically with an accuracy of up to 100 meters to facilitate search and rescue operations. Previous emergency radio beacons without GPS could be located with an accuracy of up to 5 kilometers using COSPAS satellites. As I mentioned before, the COSPAS-SARSAT system consists of low Earth orbit and geostationary orbit satellites. LEOSAR, the COSPAS-SARSAT LEOSAR system uses polar orbiting satellites, with an orbital period of approximately 120 minutes. The satellites view an area of the Earth over 6,000 kilometers wide as they orbit the globe. However, it has limitations due to intermittent coverage by these satellites. Low-altitude orbiting satellites create a strong Doppler effect in the uplink signal, allowing for Doppler positioning techniques. When the LEOSAR system detects distress alert, it calculates the location of the distress event using Doppler processing techniques. Doppler processing is based upon the principle that the frequency of the distress beacon, as heard by the satellite instrument, is affected by the relative velocity of the satellite with respect to the beacon. By monitoring the change of the beacon frequency of the received beacon signal and knowing the exact position of the satellite, the LEOSAR system is able to calculate the location of the beacon with an accuracy of within 5 to 10 kilometers. The satellite system takes 90 minutes on average to calculate the initial position from a beacon which is not GPS equipped, but it may take up to 5 hours, depending on the conditions. The LEOSAR system operates in two coverage modes, namely local and global coverage. Local coverage mode: a repeater on board the satellite relays the EPIRB signals directly to ground where it is received and processed by a LUT. If both a beacon and a LUT are simultaneously within view of a satellite, the EPIRB transmissions can be processed immediately. A satellite covers an area within approximately 2,000 km either side of its track over the ground. If a LUT is not within view of a satellite, the information from the EPIRB which is relayed to Earth is lost. This fact limits the detection and location of EPIRBs operating in the real-time mode to particular geographical areas surrounding a LUT. Global coverage mode, signals from an activated 406 MHz EPIRB are frequency and time tagged and stored in the satellite's memory. As the satellite's path brings it into view of a LUT, information, including the beacon unique identifier, frequency of detection and time of detection, is continuously relayed down to the LUT. The global coverage mode is so described because it does not suffer the geographical limitations of the real-time mode and allows detection and location anywhere on the Earth's surface. It is this fact that makes 406 MHz EPIRBs acceptable for the GNSS. The LUT, after computing the location of the emergency beacon using Doppler processing, transmits an alert message to its associated MCC. The MCC performs matching and merging of alert messages with other messages received, sorts the data geographically, and subsequently transmits a distress message to another MCC, an appropriate search and rescue authority such as a National Rescue Coordination Center, RCC, or a foreign SAR point of contact, SPOC. GEOSAR, geostationary satellites orbit the Earth at an altitude of 36,000 km, with an orbit period of 24 hours, thus appearing fixed relative to the Earth at approximately 0 degrees latitude, i.e. over the equator. A single geostationary satellite provides GEOSAR uplink coverage of about one-third of the globe, except for polar regions. Therefore, three geostationary satellites equally spaced in longitude can provide continuous coverage of all areas of the globe between approximately 70 degrees north and 70 degrees south latitude. In order to make effective use of search and rescue instruments in geostationary orbits, new 406 MHz distress beacons have been introduced with the capability to accept position information from internal or external navigation devices such as GPS receivers. This has the potential to provide near-instantaneous alerting and locating via the GEOSAR system. A GPS-equipped beacon has a location accuracy of 120 meters and location is provided by GEO satellites within minutes. When the two systems are combined, COSPAS-SARSAT is able to provide a robust capability by providing global LEOSAR coverage, near-instantaneous GEOSAR coverage, independent LEOSAR Doppler positioning, high probability of detection with the LEOSAR system anywhere on land or at sea, even in situations where obstacles block the beacon transmission to a GEOSAR satellite. High system capacity. The satellites in the two types of orbit are considered complementary. While the GEO satellites offer near-instantaneous detection of 406 MHz distress beacons, they do not provide Doppler locating capabilities and their field of view is limited to the area between 70 degrees north and 70 degrees south. The LEO satellites provide global coverage and Doppler locating capabilities but have an inherent delay given their orbital characteristics and field of view. What happens when an EPIRB is activated? Each EPIRB in the world has a unique identifier. The identity includes a three-digit country code. This is the country that takes responsibility for storing that particular EPIRB's registration details. When an EPIRB is activated in an emergency, it begins to transmit radio signals that includes also its identity number. After receipt of EPIRB signals, the satellite relays the signals to a LUT. LEOLIT and GEOLIT Earth-based ground stations receive and process distress alerts from EPIRBs relaying distress information, comprising casualty ID, position and UTC time to mission control centers. Their main purpose and function is to relay EPIRB distress alert information to the appropriate MRCC, who coordinates the deployment of search and rescue units in the search and rescue region in which the casualty is located. MRCC will then decode the country code from the message. After that, they will access the registration database for that country and expect to find details of the vessel to which the EPIRB belongs to, its radio equipment and who to contact. Then, they will start with SAR operation. SAR vessel, helicopter, plane involved in SAR operation will try to find EPIRB based on its radio signal with the direction-finding equipment. In conclusion, EPIRB and the COSPAS-SARSAT system provide a reliable rescue system in emergency situations at sea and far from the shore. These technologies play a crucial role in ensuring the safety of seafarers, offering swift detection and coordinated rescue efforts. I hope you found this information helpful. Thank you for your attention.